Good morning, one and all present over here. I am Tamalika Chakraborty, Assistant Professor of Guru Nanak Institute of Pharmaceutical Science and Technology. And today I will be discussing about the importance of plagiarism in academic writing. As a part of enrolled students of academic writing course in SWAM NPTEL. Now the question is, what is plagiarism and why we are so concerned with plagiarism, right? Like as an academician, as a researcher, right, we write a lot of papers, articles, books, and now all of a sudden, if you are caught of an offense that you have actually theft, you have actually stolen somebody else's idea, then that will be a mishap in your career. So one should stop plagiarism, that is. Usually people say that it is copying and borrowing, but it is a much more serious offense than copying and borrowing. That is why Merriam and Webster has given the actual definition of plagiarism, that is to steal and pass off as your own idea, which is very, very wrong. To use someone else's production without credit. You are not giving credit to somebody else's production, or you are utilizing it to commit literary theft. And also to modify somebody else's idea and make some new idea and calling it novel is also plagiarism. So all these things have to be kept in mind before we move on to write a paper or write an article in near future. Next question is, words and ideas can be stolen. Is it true? It is words and ideas are not objects. So how it is stolen? But in actual answer is yes, it is stolen. Why? Because according to US law and any laws of other countries as well, production of original novel idea is considered as IPR, intellectual property right, somebody's intellect, somebody's novelty, right, and has to be protected by copyright laws. Hence, your words and ideas of course can be stolen. The next question is that what are the different ways by which you can detect plagiarism? That means how will you understand that these are plagiarism? So that is why I have made a list, right, which is actually plagiarism, like converting someone else's work as your own, copying a sentence and changing the word without giving the credit. That means you are copying a sentence and you are changing its word without giving a credit. That is wrong. Failing to put quotation mark, which is very, very important. Failing to cite a reference for an information, writing in academic writing. And of course, giving wrong information about the source. Like I give you an example. See, in the bottom of this slide, I have put one picture. But I have cited the source. So if I not cite the source and put the picture, then that is a plagiarism, of course. Next, we will move on to the classification of plagiarism, the various types of plagiarism. So first is your direct plagiarism, as you see the symbol cut and paste. So we often cut and paste, we often take a part from the Wikipedia and paste it somewhere else. So when a person copy word to word without any acknowledgement, then that is cut and paste. Like I give you one example, in the bottom you see I have taken one line, attention, changing the words of an original source is not sufficient to prevent plagiarism. I have taken this sentence from Turnitin.com and I have modified it as, one has to remember that changing the word of original source is not sufficient to prevent plagiarism. So this patch is similar to the previous. I have just copied, cut and paste over there. So this is your cut and paste plagiarism, and which should be avoided. The first priority that it should be avoided. Next is your self-plagiarism, self, one's own. Like for example, you have done a previous work, you have some data and you want to incorporate the data in a second paper, right? And you are not taking the permission of the professor, the co-author who helped you, who is with you. This is plagiarism. Like for example, if you have done some work in first paper and you are trying to put it into your second research paper without citing it, then that is also self-plagiarism. And of course, whether it is your work, of course, and you are putting it somewhere else, that is also plagiarism. So self-plagiarism also have to be avoided. Next is a mosaic plagiarism. As the name suggests, mosaic. Mosaic means patch. So when I'm talking of mosaic plagiarism, you know that you are inserting a phrase without give a quotation, without giving a quotation. Or you are paraphrasing a structured sentence having the same meaning and you have put it in the same place, right? Then that is also a punishable offense. Like I have given you an example. Like I have put one particular sentence from Turnitin.com. And you see that most cases of plagiarism can be avoided, however, by citing sources. This is there in Turnitin.com. And I have modified it as one can avoid plagiarism by citing sources. So this is a patch, a phrase which I have taken without any quotation mark. So that is plagiarism. And after that, you see in the bold, acknowledging that some of the materials has been borrowed, etc. This portion is similar to what is there in the Turnitin.com in the same structured manner. But I have paraphrased it. So this is also plagiarism, and this plagiarism is a patch plagiarism, patch that is your mosaic plagiarism. Next is your accidental plagiarism. You plagiarize by accident. That means when you unintentionally paraphrase a sentence, mistakenly forgets a quote, a sentence, or forget to cite a source, the part of your accidental plagiarism. Now, you know why this accident occurs? When you are unaware, when you are ignorant, right? So if you don't know what is plagiarism, what type of plagiarism it persists, of course you will do paraphrase unintentionally. Of course you will mistake without giving a quote. Of course you will not be able to cite a source. So this is basically your accidental plagiarism. So what is the best method to avoid accidental plagiarism? To be aware about plagiarism, and that is why this video. Next come the importance of consequences. Like as a researcher, we should know that what is the consequences of plagiarism. Otherwise, we will never avoid it. We'll do it again and again. We'll repeat it again and again. First, destroy student's reputation. A student have plagiarized, copied. So what will happen? The teacher will not believe that student, will not give a good marks. Even the teacher can reject the project, reject the article which the student has actually prepared, right? So that is the destruction of your student's reputation. As a professional, if you are plagiarizing, what will happen? It will destroy your professional reputation. Nobody will believe you, because you have copied someone's work. Even it is punishable offense, your job may go. You may be terminated from your service. If you have certain registration of your PhD, that registration will be cancelled. Your thesis will be rejected, right? So these are many ways by which your reputation will be destroyed. Destroyed academic reputation. At the very beginning of the slide, I have told you that you are a good academician, but all of a sudden you come to know that you are actually caught in an offense of plagiarism. So what will happen? Your reputation will be destroyed, and nobody will actually try to collaborate with you, try to communicate with you, try to accept your research paper in your near future, because you are marked as a plagiarized individual. Plagiarize a researcher who is in plagiarism. Legal repercussion. There are many legal repercussions. You may have to go to the court, right? You may be punishable. You get punishable offense. It's a punishable offense. You may be punished, right? You may be infringed because of plagiarism. And last is your monetary repercussion. That means you may have to give a lot of money because you have actually copied it. Right? Like for example, many years before, you know that the Samsung tried to copy it from Apple, right? Apple iPhone. So what happened? That particular brand has to be stopped. That means that was banned in the market, and a huge amount of monetary money has to be given to the company, right? So this is your monetary repercussion, which is one of the greatest consequence of your plagiarism anywhere, whether it is a research, whether it is in technology, whether it is in literary, whatever it is. So the best way is to be novel and to stop plagiarism. So I think from my above previous slide, I have put a light. Focused a light on various types of plagiarism, such that in near future you can understand that whether you are plagiarizing or not, and The main aim of this particular video is to stop plagiarism in research, and so I will request you, all of you, to go into the other details of the plagiarism as well, right? And to stop plagiarism of research article, of books, of papers, etc. in your near future. So be novel. Be novel. Develop novel work, right? And gather your patent. I have basically collected all this information from NPTEL course on academic writing. There are videos which are of great benefit. So people can also enroll in this particular course to know more about academic writing. I've also got this information from Turnitin.com. This Turnitin.com is that particular database or tool in which they basically use to detect plagiarism. Authenticate is one of the tool to detect plagiarism and very accurately, right? So whoever is writing a research article should go to the Authenticate as well as Turnitin to check whether they have plagiarized or not. If they have plagiarized, what percentage of plagiarism is there? That has to be checked before the submission of any article or thesis, etc. These are my feedback that I am very much lecturing videos are interesting and informative. Webinars are interactive, and I have interacted in the webinars. And course materials are very simple and readers friendly, such that everybody will understand about this basics of your academic writing. Last but not the least, I want to acknowledge academic writing team who is actually conducting the course of SWAM NPTEL for their guidance, for their mentorship, for their help, etc. Thank you once again. Thank you to the academic writing team.